Dear students, the next traffic study I'm going to discuss is the parking studies. So we all know that nowadays parking is very important because due to an increase in the number of vehicles, a tremendous increase can be seen in the number of vehicles that is using on using roadways. So this is again reflected in the number of vehicles that require parking on roadways. So in due to these reasons, parking studies have become very important, particularly in the case of large towns and cities where we can see parking, to avail parking it is very difficult, very difficult. So the parking will be leading to different difficulties for the road users and the people living there, like congestions may be occurred, then accidents will be occurring during parking and unparking operations, then there will be environmental pollution due to the starting and stopping of vehicles, there will be obstructions to emergency vehicles like this, you can see ambulances, etc. There will be obstructions caused. So these are the main reasons. Then access to houses will be blocked by these parked vehicles, etc. So these are few effects or few ill effects due to parking. So in order to overcome all this, you have to provide sufficient parking areas, particularly in case of large towns and cities. So while we are talking parking studies, the different aspects covered during parking studies include study of existing parking characteristics and facilities available, inventory of additional parking facilities that could be availed, determination of actual parking demand during different periods of the day, planning and design of suitable parking facilities that are suitable to meet the demand, keeping in view the available space for parking facility. So if you are taking the parking characteristics, you will be dealing with the existing existing parking facilities. So you can identify what is the parking pattern, whether we are having on street, that is curb parking, that is adjacent to road, or whether we are having off street parking, like separate parking lots are available or not, and what is the capacity of these parking spaces, etc. can be identified. Then what is the interference to the smooth flow of traffic during parking and unparking operations? Then what about the accidents involved during the parking and unparking maneuvers? And what about the walking distance from the parked space to the destination? Maybe a consumer may be reaching a place for some shopping purpose, etc. So he may be parking the vehicle at some space and he will be walking to that that particular shop, etc. So what is the distance he has walked after parking? That also you can study. So these are the parking characteristics we are identifying or studying. Then you can go for parking space inventory. So here we are identifying which are the places or spaces that can be converted into parking spaces. So a map showing all these facilities, curb, both curb and off-street parking facilities that are that can be converted to parking spaces. So map showing all curb parking and off-street parking facilities that can be provided and is prepared by analyzing the data. And the factors considered while designing or preparing these sketches: traffic flow along the adjoining roads. So if the traffic flow is very high, you have to reduce the on-street parking. Like you can provide parking only on one side, or you will not be permitting parking. You have to provide some off-street parking. You will not be permitting parking on roads which is having very high traffic and with this low, that is road capacity is low. So both these things go and in hand in hand, that is roadway capacity and traffic flow. If traffic flow is very high and road capacity is less, we will not be able to provide parking space on that road, or either you will be have to restrict the parking on one side of road. So such things you can do. Then you can identify what is the parking demand. So if demand is high, you can provide more space. The space is available. Then the maximum space that can be availed for different class of vehicles, like two-wheeler parking, four-wheeler parking, etc. Like that also you can classify the parking space. So you are identifying all the spaces available and you are making based on the parking demand only. And then you are preparing a map showing all these facilities. Then you can go for parking demand. So parking demand means what is the needed, required parking space. So you can see different terms that will be coming under parking demand. So parking accumulation. So it is the number of vehicles that are parked in a given area during a specified time period. That means if you are having an area and you are specifying a time period like this, like 1 hour. So what is the number of vehicles parked in that area. Then parking duration, it is the length of time a vehicle spends in a parking space. Then parking occupancy, it is the number of spaces occupied in a parking lot expressed as percentage of total parking spaces available. So if a parking lot is having 100 parking spaces and only 50 is used at a time, it means 50% is the parking occupancy. Then parking turnover, so it is the number of times a parking space has been used during the day. So if you are having a parking slot, it may be used by 3 vehicles only a day. So that is the number of times a parking space has been used during a day. Then for analyzing parking demand, you can also use this curve, that is parking accumulation curve. So parking in parking accumulation curve, you are having time of the day in x-axis, and on y-axis you are having number of vehicles parked during that time. So here you can see from 10 to 10, 15, the number of vehicles around 3, like that. You are having at different times of day, what is the number of vehicles parked in that space that you will get. And the area of this curve will give you the parking demand. The area under this curve will give you parking demand. Then there are other methods for determining parking demand. So they are license plate survey, cordon counts, user information surveys. So in license plate survey, you are having different methods for counting the license plate, or to count the parking space that is required based on license plate survey. One method is, or one form is like this. You can enter the name of the street, you can enter the side that is left or right, you can enter the date of study, then from where to where we are doing the survey, that you can note. Then the main thing is, you will be noting the space number. You can either note it as space number or this much meters, like that also you can note. Then you have to, you will be having split ups like this 4 times. So here this means at 8 a.m. I am reaching that parking space 1. You will have to note here what is the register number of the vehicle. So if I am saying a vehicle with register number 123, you note that 123 here. Then at 8:30 a.m. you are again reaching that place. So you are just walking. Suppose it is a 500 meter stretch. You are walking from one end to other. Then again we are reaching the initial position and again walking again that 500 meters. So at 8 a.m. you are starting from one end, then again 8:30 a.m. you are reaching that other end again at 8:30 a.m. Then at 9 a.m. again you are reaching that end. So like that you have to plan the survey. Then at 8 a.m. you will be seeing 123, vehicle 123 at that parking space. Then you are reaching there for again. At 8:30 a.m. you are reaching there. Then again you are seeing 123, means you note that register number here, 123. Then at 9 a.m. also you may be seeing 123, vehicle with register number 123. You note that 123 here. Only one vehicle in one space. So 123 is the register number. So at 9 a.m. you are seeing again that vehicle there itself. But at 9:30 a.m. you may not be seeing that vehicle. Or maybe another vehicle 456, register number 456 will be seeing here. So you can note here 456. If vehicle is not there, you can keep it blank. So like that. So you can see from 8 to 9:30 a.m. vehicle 123 with register number 123 have parked in that area. So it has parked there for 1.5 hours. So like that you can identify the data. So that is license plate survey. Then cordon count means you are selecting an area and you are counting the vehicles coming to that area, that is incoming vehicles, and you are counting the number of vehicles outgoing. So the difference between incoming and outgoing will give you the vehicles that are parked in that area. So that is cordon count. Suppose you are selecting an area, 200 vehicles comes in, but only 150 goes out, means 50 vehicles are parked in that area. So like that also you can do the parking demand. Then user information survey. So there you are personally interviewing the drivers who are parking the vehicles in that area, and from them you can collect the details like what duration you are parking, what is the purpose you are parking, whether you are using that area for all days or whether only weekends or whether weekdays. So like that data can be collected. So these are the different methods for collecting parking demand. Then parking can be again types of parking. It can be classified into two types, on-street or curb parking and off-street parking. So on-street or curb parking means the parking along the curb or on curb. So that will be adjacent to the road. If this is the main road or the roadway, then adjacent to that roadway you will be providing spaces like this for parking of vehicle. It is known as curb or on-street parking. So vehicles are parked on the curb, and it can be of two types, angle parking and parallel parking. So angle parking means like this, it can be a 90 degree angle, 60 degree or 30 degree angle, then 45 degree angle like this. So this is known as angle parking. So if this will be the roadway and the vehicles will be parked like this. Here this will be the roadway here in middle, then the parking spaces will be marked like this. So it is angle parking. Then parallel parking means the parking spaces will be parallel to the roadway, or it is also known as 0 degree parking. So this will be the roadway, the vehicles will be parked like this. This is one parking slot, second one, then third, fourth, etc. So in between you have to provide some space for parking and unparking maneuvers. So it is mainly useful in areas where we are having less width for roadway, or if the traffic flow is very high. So in such areas we can go for this type of parking. That is curb parking. Then off-street parking means there we are providing some areas exclusively for parking away from the traffic stream. So that is off-street parking. So areas exclusively allotted for parking which will be some distance away from the mainstream of traffic. So there you will be having entry point and exit point like this, and sometimes you will have to pay some parking fee also. So either you will have to provide at entry, or based on the time duration you have to provide the parking fee at exit. So you can park at some slots provided like this. It can be again divided into two types, parking lots and multi-floor parking garages. So parking lots means you will be having areas like this, a large area like this, and there the parking spaces will be divided like this for each vehicle. So it is known as parking lots. And then we are having multi-floor parking garages. So it is mainly seen in the case of large shopping malls or commercial buildings, or where we are having large offices, etc. So there you can go for multi-floor car parking. So it is the demand of today, because we are having a large parking demand, so the space available is less, so you can go for multi-floor parking. So a large number of vehicles can be parked when compared to the ground area that is used for parking. So here you can connect the different floors by using ramp. So you have to design the ramp like ramp and all, because it should not be too slope and all. So that you have to decide. So like that you can design the ramp, and these different floors can be connected by using these ramps. So that is multi-floor parking. So these are the types of parking: curb parking and off-street parking. So that's about parking studies. Okay, thank you.